on a foo-foo haircut, sitting on my heel. I want a foo-foo haircut, sitting on my head. Man, I'd rather be bald, I'd rather be dead. Now, the best in my generation been destroyed by styling moves. Some of the best in my generation been destroyed by that evil styling moves. Yeah, there's only one new set, Bowie's on the loose. Don't be like Charlie Sexton, a prisoner to your hair. Don't be like Charlie Sexton, a prisoner to your hair. Might wind up on a magazine looking like a nut. Them New York hair farmers with their hair sticking up so high. Man, if you get caught in a fan, them poor boys, they might die. Man, that'd be a shame. It would be a pity. You know, one morning I woke up from a nice night of sleeping. I woke up and I said to myself, Mojo, Mojo, you cannot judge a foo-foo by his haircut. You can't judge a book by its cover. You can't decide, you know, a person's good or bad just because they got one of them big poofter haircuts sticking up. Mojo, there might be a great cosmic kid inside one of them people. One of them people with all dressed in black and looking all like they're going to die and everything. They're just regular folks like me and you. Them heavy metal guys, they're regular folks like me and you. And for brotherhood, for peace, fraternity, equality, I decided that I, Mojo Nixon, was going to get a foo-foo haircut. That's right, in the war between the rockers and the poofters. God damn it. So I went and got me one of them haircuts, man. I'm talking about a mighty big one. They had to get a hair extension piece on me, man. Sticking 3-4 feet up the air. Big black thing, a lot of styling moose on it. Bees, birds, and bats were flying all around that sucker. Looked like a couple of bats had a nest up in there or something. Might have been vampire bats or something, you know. God dang it, man. So I'm sitting there and I'm walking around. Everybody's seeing me and they're saying, Moj, we're so bummed out, Mojo. We can't believe, Mojo, you got a foo-foo haircut. I said, I did it all for brotherhood. I did it all for brotherhood. So one Sunday afternoon, you know what I do? I go down to my local go-kart track, man, and I get in that there little go-kart. And I think I'm gonna take off like Wendell Scott, and the guy that owns the place, he comes up to me and says,
Say, Moj, I know you like go-karts a whole lot and everything, but that haircut, Mojo, you can't be racing with that haircut. Not only are the bats scaring everybody, but you might poke somebody's eye out with that thing. I mean, it's just way up there, Mojo, it's out of control. I know that haircut helps you get in them New York clubs and everything, make you feel real existential and whatnot, but no go-karts, Mojo.
I thought about this for a second. I was mighty discombobulated. I said to myself, discombobulation is a sweep in the nation, and no on a foo-foo haircut sitting on my head. No on a foo-foo haircut sitting on my head. Man, I'd rather be bald, I'd rather be dead.